Hey folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and today I have the absolute pleasure of showcasing for you the brand new, as we're recording this video right now, Blackstar ID Core version 4s in all of their glory. Let's get into it. Now off the bat, I highly recommend using headphones to watch this video because we've got this hooked up stereo, because the ID Cores from Blackstar have some of the most awesome stereo spread you've ever heard. They fill the entire room, they're just magic. Actually, it's kind of... yeah, it's good, man. So, anyways, getting ahead of myself. The ID Cores from Blackstar have been out for a number of years right now, and they haven't really messed with the recipe too much. They just keep adding to it, and that's exactly what's up with the version 4s right now. The reason they're not really changing the recipe is because they're one of the best-selling, best-sounding, most portable, most awesome amplifiers on the planet for the price. Like, they're small, they're lightweight, they pack a punch, they're the ideal beginner starter guitar amp. Like, I believe over any other amplifier, these are the best-selling ones. They're so, in any of its incarnations, let's say. They're great for the beginners out there because they do so much, tons of sounds, tons of effects, super easy to use, but they're also one of the best portable practice amplifiers for the more seasoned guitar players out there on the move. Because not only can you plug them up via the wall, like a normal amplifier, you can also power them with the little Blackstar PB1, the little power banks, these things. Got some USBs on there as well, and a handy torch, because musicians need torches and stuff, so yeah, you can power them and be portable with one of these little power supplies, or just plug it into the wall like I am today. Now, we've got the ID Core 10, the 20, which you're going to hear today in this video, and the 40, corresponding to 10, 20, and 40 watts. These, like I said, are great amplifiers for the guitar and stuff. You're going to hear them more shortly, but I know so many people, myself included sometimes, use these because they've got such a great stereo spread, hook them up to your TV. Use them as a speaker for your TV, hook them up for your computer when you're gaming, when you're watching YouTube videos and stuff. They're fantastic speakers in themselves, minus all the guitar stuff. Now let's get into the guitar stuff. Joyous little thing to play, and that's why it's one of the most popular industry-leading amplifiers on the planet. Thank you, Blackstar. So yeah, super easy to use, some funky new aesthetics as well. So the top is like brushed, has a brushed look now, where previously it was all shiny and gloss. It's kind of more boutique-y almost, and all brushed up top. But it's the connectivity and the things you can do with these besides sounding like an amplifier is what really sets it apart. These are great for the modern-day guitar player that likes to live stream. Like do like Instagram lives and Facebook lives and stuff, and have a guitar, not have the mic and guitar up, have it through an interface, going into your phone or whatever, or just using your phone microphone. So you can get these funky little Blackstar TRRS cables. Right, so this is totally stereo in, stereo out. Plug this into your ID core, then into the headphone input jack thing of your phone, and get all the tones from your in stereo from your ID core going directly into your phone. So when you do live streams with guitar stuff, you get the tones from this going directly to your audience, to your fans. That's just another awesome little feature of these amplifiers and why you should get one whether you're a pro or a beginner. So the feature set is amazing, but the feature set is nothing without awesome tones. Okay, and one of the funky new features for the version 4 is that in either the 10, the 20, or the 40, you can run it down, well, you can ramp it down to 1 watt. Why on earth would you do that? These are digital modeling almost amplifiers. Surely you just have a bit of fun with the volume and it sounds the same regardless. That's not necessarily the case, because these are modeled after, not really modeling, they're modeled like after big valve amplifiers, the best sounding amplifiers on the planet. And valve amps, the louder they are, the valves are cooking a bit more, especially with the distorted tones, and they sound a bit sweeter, they sound a bit more lovely when you turn it down. Not that they lose that, but they lose a little bit of special seasoning almost. That kind of thing's in the ID cores as well. So when you crank it, when you crank the gain, when you crank the volume, I'm not gonna crank the volume, you might blow your speakers up, Alex, is it good? Still good? When you crank it, right? By essence, it gets louder because you're cranking it, but you get a bit more sizzle, you get a bit more kind of secret sauce on it. And sometimes that's too loud, people. Bring it down to 1 watt with a new button on the version 4. And whether you're recording, get that tone at a manageable level. Get those faux valves sizzling in your ID core, but not blow the windows out. Again, carrying on from the amazing feature set, the amazing tones, that's all well and good if it's not easy to use. And one of the main things with the ID cores is it's really just plug in and play. You can delve a bit deeper, and I'm gonna talk about that more in a second, but literally plug in the amplifier, choose from one of the six voicings on the left, from clean, bright, clean, warm, crunch, super crunch, OD1 and OD2. And get all the sounds you'd ever want. One gain control, how much saturations you want. One volume, how loud you want it to be. And of course, it features Blackstar's patented ISF control, which is an infinite shape feature, which is the EQ on this. But it's an EQ in the way that it gives you more tonal variety, because it shifts where the mid sits of your tone. Do you want it to sound more like an American amplifier? Like a Mesa Boogie or something like that? Or more like a British amplifier, something like a Marshall or something like that? Fun little feature to have, and you can totally shape your tone so it sounds lovely for you. Moving on from that, talking about all the super wide loveliness with this, it's got tons, well, 12 lovely built-in effects, modulations, reverbs, delays. Clean stuff here. It's some of the most wonderful, swirly, gorgeous, even like, auto was. And the rest. It's all controlled by the effects block over there. So the main control is split into four. The more you go up, each fourth of like little quadrants almost, the more intense the effect gets until it turns into the next quadrant, let's say, and all controlled level-wise with the control. On the right there, the 20 and the 40 are foot switchable. Save presets within them, but the 10 isn't. So foot switch on the 20 and the 40 if you want to gig with them. One of the fun new features is the 40 down there, the big 40 watt one. That's actually louder than the previous ones. I've had a software update and a bit of a hardware update, and now it's louder and clearer than ever. Not the old one wasn't, but this is, I think tonal frequencies go from that to that with the 40 with the version 4s. So you've got your stunning feature set, all the cool things it can do. You've got your stunning sounds going from clean stuff to distorted stuff. You've got your stunning, really wide stereo effects over on the right, and it's super easy to use. What's not to love? Well, I'll tell you what's not to love. If you're one of the guys and girls out there that like to delve a bit deeper and tweak your tone so it's perfect for you, there's not really a lot on the top right here to do that. That, ladies and gentlemen, is when you'll plug it into the computer via USB. So with a USB on the top of this, you can either use it in the way I'm going to tell you, or use it to record, like use this as an audio interface. Like I said, with the live streaming on your phone, USB this into your computer, get all the tones from your ID core, record with them in your recording software of choice. Plug it into your computer with the cable it comes with, and download Blackstar's Architect software. And the Architect software allows you to tweak and manipulate parameters that you don't see on the top right here. so you can tweak and manipulate effects, extra little bits and bobs. Most importantly, you can save your patches on there. So if you go to your friend's house and you have your laptop and stuff and they've got an ID core, you can download your patches into their amplifier and get your tone. You can save patches to the online cloud, like get some famous sounds that other people have saved and browse and share and have loads of fun with different tones that people have crafted and download them via the Architect app, it's a program thing, then pop them in your ID core. With that as well, you also get to have a bit of fun with Blackstar's Cab Rig Lite software. Now, Cab Rig is something you'll find in the big St. James's that I use and the new HT series amplifiers. Cab Rig is a line-out cab emulation software thing, fancy feature. And the ID cores have the Lite version of it. So with the headphone output, you get obviously the sound of your ID core, but you get emulated cabs, like almost like Blackstar's impulse responses, almost. But it's, you can delve a bit deeper than you can with an impulse response with Cab Rig. So with the Cab Rig software, you can choose different sizes of cabs, different speakers, different mics, different placements, and tweak it perfectly to your ears. All of that in the ID core. If you download the extra programs and stuff and USB to your computer, but as a standalone unit, like I say, as soon as you plug it in, just great. Well done. Tune is on. So what else is there to add that I've missed out? Obviously they all have two speakers in because they're totally stereo. The 10 watts have 3-inch speakers, two 3-inch speakers, two 5-inch on the 20 and 6.5-inch on the 40. Wonderful Blackstar design speakers that give you that stereo spread, which is just wonderful. If you want to get one for yourself, there's a link in the description box down below so you can check one out at pmtonline.co.uk and comment down below what you think of these wonderful amplifiers. Let's hear them some more, shall we? This is Super Crunch. Gains at like 2 o'clock, EQs at 9 o'clock. Responding like a real amplifier, so the volume of your guitar and anything that's hitting the preamp section, it responds and it's lovely and spongy and nice. There's no shame in turning the delay off all the way, closing your eyes and pretending you're Def Leppard sound checking in an empty stadium. We'll be right back. modulation. So the tap tempo for the delay is obviously the taps when you want the repeats to come in, and it's the rate for the modulation. I do believe that, ladies and gentlemen, is all the sight specs and sounds I can give you from the wonderful brand new version 4 Blackstar ID Cores. Let me know what you think down below in the comments, and if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and hit subscribe. We are playing music today on all social media platforms. You'll find me at Dagan Wilkin on Instagram. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.